Okay, let's get a very interesting part of this conversation about business law. Yesterday, the Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, spoke glowingly about the cooperation between the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary, and what has been done on the side of laws relating to business. And that's why this morning we've got the chairman of the MBA section on business law, Olumide Akpata here, who is also a senior partner at Templars. Akpata has been spent about the last 20 years in Nigeria's legal profession, and he's one who has done a lot of transaction side on commercial law. So let's, he's also involved in M&A, just in case you want to have some corporate marriage. Good morning. It's good to have you.
Good to be here.
This is big. If we start from what has been done in terms of Nigeria's move towards the Africa CFTA, I'm sure you're aware. Just about a week ago, Dr. Osakwe's, Professor Osakwe's buddy met and tried to finalize the papers and present it to the president. And say, look, Nigeria needs to sign. But if you bring in heavyweights like yourself from Nigeria and around the world, and your business law section of Nigerian Bar Association, of which you're sitting on the council, and the chairman, is doing this together, you think it's good to have this conversation in Nigeria?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, absolutely. As you know, the Ambassador Osakwe Nigerian Office for Trade Negotiation, Ambassador Osakwe is part of the Interministerial Committee directed by the President to carry out consultations around the country on the back of Nigeria's hesitation, as it were, or decision not to sign for now the Africa Continental Free Trade Agreement. So Ambassador Osakwe's that group, the committee, have gone around the country, the geopolitical zones, and so they are at the point where they are harnessing or they are putting together all the feedback that they've received from around the country to go back to Mr. President and to let him know exactly what the pulse of the nation is with regard to that particular the agreement. So by some fortuitous coincidence, our conference is also happening during this period, the conference of the Nigeria Bar Association section on business law. And the theme for that conference is bringing down the barriers of trade, law as a vehicle for bringing down the barriers of trade. And I tell you honestly that we had picked on this theme a long time ago, even before Nigeria decided not to sign the agreement, because we felt we were on the cusp of a new Africa, and we thought we should discuss it at the conference. Mm. So now the conference presents itself as a veritable platform for continuing the consultation.
Business law. And you can do nothing without business law.
Absolutely.
That is right in enabling the business environment. How far do you think we've done in the last few years?
Oh, let me stick with the last year.
Yes.
Right? I am excited. I think we've done quite well in terms of law being a tool for enabling business. And I heard on the clip that the clip about the Vice President's comments yesterday, the MBA, the section on business law, we have worked with the PEBEC, Presidential Council on Ease of Doing Business, for well over a year on dealing with the laws that impede business. So quite a number of laws have been reviewed with our active support. I'm sure you're aware of the passage of the Companies and Allied Matters Act, which is, for me, epochal. It is just, for us in the legal profession, it's a major, major achievement. And the section on business law, we take pride in the fact that we're part of that process. So law reform is critical to the ease of doing business, not just laws, but also regulations. And so we've been working with the Secretariat of the PEBEC, ensuring that we are on hand to draft regulations that by themselves impede business from straight off the bat, before we talk about mindset change and the other things.
Yeah, we'll get to mindset change. But again, if you look at the trade laws or the trade agreements we've signed, whether with the IOCs, what they call the JVs, and the rest, it looks like we always get the short end of the carrot all the time. What do you think is wrong with the folks that signed this agreement?
Well, if you ask me one of the achievements of this administration, I would say quickly is the setting up of the Nigeria Office for Trade Negotiation. It's quite clear, if you go to any of those trade negotiations without being prepared, you will get probably not even any bit of the stick if you're not ready. You know what I mean?
You won't get both the carrots and the stick.
No carrots and stick. You know what I mean? And the problem we've had up until now is the fact that the haphazard approach to trade negotiation.
No coordination.
No coordination. When trade negotiation of itself is almost a science. The Trade Department in America, I am told there are about 1,000 lawyers. I'm told. So it is, those countries don't go to, trade negotiations are not a tea party. They don't go there unprepared. And so I was.
So it's not just a job for ministers or PAMSECs to say we're flying to Brussels, we're going to whatever, and just sign on behalf of Nigeria, yes, ABC. Put it on the paper. And we expect the country.
Recipe for disaster. You know, so those kind of trips must be, or those kind of voyages must be underpinned, undergirded by intense preparation. You know, trade law is such a delicate, very technical area. So I'm delighted that we now have the Nigeria Office for Trade Negotiation. We have Ambassador Sakwe at the helm. You know his credentials, you know his pedigree. So, and also the section on business law of the Nigeria Bar Association, we, in the course of our conference, we'll be talking trade, and we are trying to encourage Nigerian lawyers to take an interest in trade, international trade law.
Why is it important at this time? There's a trade war going on.
You said it yourself. You know, you're about to go into the Africa Continental Free Trade Agreement, sign or not sign. If Nigeria signs or does not sign, 44 countries have signed. It is almost imminent or inevitable that there will be some kind of agreement in place on the continent. And we would need to, whether we are part of it or outside of it, we would need to negotiate a trade agreement. So you see what's going on between America
and China and the EU
and so on and so forth. You know, we just cannot afford not to hone our skills or to get the experts to be at the fore, to lead the charge. And like you said, not the political office holders. The experts should be leading the charge.
In terms of cross-border trade, look at our West Africa neighbors, in terms of rice, chicken, poultry, whatever is coming in, and we haven't been able to really tackle that smuggling using the neighboring countries as a dumping ground for us. Do you think we need experts to help us craft something that will work within the ECOWAS, common tariff, whatever agreement, relationships we've had over decades in which Nigeria plays significant roles?
I think is important is that we, for example, in the AFCTA, there are provisions in there that provide safeguards for nascent or infant industries or sectors, right? So, and that should be replicated even at the ECOWAS level. This is one of the things that came out of the consultation that the NOTN and the Ministerial Committee have done. There are safeguards, so where you know that there are sectors delicate, or sectors that are in infancy, the agreement allows for the side negotiation of the rules that would apply to those sectors. So because if we haven't dealt with the borders, as you know, borders, smuggling, these are not issues that we can legislate about or by legislative fiat deal with. We must, they're issues that have to be contended with mano a mano, as it were. If those are not in place, it is possible under the Africa Free Trade Agreement to negotiate, a specific regime, or you know what I mean, in the interim until you are able to sort out those areas, which is one of the attractions of the agreement. So at the ECOWAS level, I'm sure that can be replicated.
We're trying to build an enabling business process. And sometimes folks say that you lawyers are to be blamed for delaying the process sometimes.
No, I totally disagree, as you would imagine. But I guess if it is about trading blames or the blame game, everybody would have their own portion of the blame. We have the courts and the processes dragging out. We have the lawyers sometimes over-lawyering agreements. I agree that, we are more of a force for good than for evil. I'm sure you would agree. So then of course we can't tie everybody with the same brush. You know, and so I'm quite certain that the lawyers that I know and I'm familiar with, and then those that I lead at the section of business law, I think we are more into enabling business than impeding it.